Hey guys, welcome back to Naughty Threats. In case you are here on my channel for the first time, do subscribe and also hit the bell icon to get all the future updates. So you guys must have watched my previous video where I demonstrated how to do these kind of motifs or crochet patches. So today I'm going to show how I'm attaching it to this sari. So it is this sari for which I worked these, and since it is like double colored, I have worked in two colors. So I have worked only so many pieces. I'm yet to work few more, but if I wait to finish all the pieces, then the part 2 will be delayed and you guys will be upset about that. So that is the reason I thought of just doing the second part with only how many ever pieces I have in hand right now. So for this, instead of directly attaching it to the pallu like this, which is also one of the option, you can just stitch it with your normal sewing needle here. But instead of doing that, I wanted to just make a baseline for the pallu first. So for that, I'm using 6 strands of silk thread in the contrast color. This is the pallu. So I am using this peach color, which is the contrast. And then I'm using the same crochet hook number 10. And in the very first step, I'm also using these 4mm gold beads. Because sari has a lot of gold zari like this, I'm using these gold beads. So I will start by fixing the knot here in the corner. So I have fixed the knot here, and then I'm going to work 2 chains and a double crochet. And I'm going to work 1 more double crochet right next to it. So after working 2 double crochets, I'm going to add this bead, and while I'm adding this bead, the needle is still in the hook. I have not removed the needle, I'm sorry, not the hook but the loop. Needle is still in this thread loop, I have not removed it, and I'm going to insert the bead like this. So after the bead is in, I'm going to yarn over and work 1 more double crochet right next to the previous one. So I'll pull a loop, and then I'm going to pass this once like this, and I'm going to pass the same loop through the bead like this, and then finish the double crochet. So when I try to add the bead in this method, what happens is the bead sits straight like this. Usually it sits like this when we add, but in this method it's like this. And then I'm going to continue working my double crochets. So I'm going to work 20 to 25 double crochets before I add my next bead. I finished working 25 double crochets, and this is where I'm going to add my next bead. So I've added the bead on the hook like this, and I'll yarn over and go into the fabric, pull a loop and come out, yarn over and pass through the 2 loops, and pass the same loop through the bead like this, and then again yarn over and pass through the remaining 2 loops. So after adding this bead, again we'll continue with 25 double crochets. So I prefer doing an odd number of double crochets here, so that when I am stitching this flower like this, we are able to fix it correctly in the center. So this is how the design is going to be. In between these 2 beads, I am going to hand stitch this motif. I have started attaching these motifs to this base that I have just worked. Now to attach it, I am using 2 strands of cotton thread. I have added 2 strands in the regular sewing needle and I have knotted it. So that makes it 4 strands altogether. In this step, I am also using these kind of pearls and gold beads, because in the blouse of this sari, I have used pearls. So we have 25 stitches here. So I'm going to fix this in the 13th stitch. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. So this is my 13th stitch. So I'm going to I'm passing the needle in between the 2 strands, and that's how the thread gets fixed. And then I'll add 1 pearl. And a small 3mm sized metal bead. And then I'm going to insert the needle here, like this. So it's always good to add some beads when we are attaching these kind of motifs, because when we add beads, it neatly hangs and it does not stay stiff. So I'm going back into both the beads. So pull this tight and then we'll go back to the wrong side, and then we will knot this thread. So how I'm going to knot is by just picking a small stitch here. And then wrap this around the needle and knot it. So I'll repeat the same step one more time. And then I'll trim this thread and add little glue. So I'm adding glue in the wrong side just to make sure there are no knots visible in the right side. So same way, we will continue adding the remaining pieces. So here is the final look. After adding all the pieces, this is how it is looking, and the distance between the two is absolutely up to you. This is one of my favorite saris, so I really wanted to do that little extra work, and that's why I've kept it a little close. And I've also added this kind of a kundan in between because it was looking too empty. However, this is completely optional. If you want to replace it with anything else also, you can do it. So this is how it looks. So do let me know in the comment section what you think about this design. And if you happen to try, don't forget to share it in our Facebook group. I would love to see your work. If you have not subscribed to my vlog channel yet, do subscribe to Kanika Reddy Vlogs, and also check out my blog naughtythreads.net. If you like this video, do give us a thumbs up, and I guess that's all in today's video. I shall see you guys soon with more interesting stuff. Until then, take care.